For the first-time convention goers among you, this General Secretary's report is a chance to share in greater detail the work carried out at Rotary offices worldwide. Because this has been an exceptionally busy year for Rotary leadership and staff, and there's a great deal of progress to report. I'm going to begin, appropriately enough, by talking about Rotary's number one organizational priority, the eradication of polio. As most of you heard this morning from Rebecca Martin of the U.S. Centers for Disease Control, the news is very, very encouraging. But it's imperative that we continue to play two key roles to get us to polio's endgame. First, we need to reach our fundraising goal of $35 million for polio eradication. Through the End Polio Now, Make History Today campaign, as you heard this morning, the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation will provide a $2 match for each dollar we spend on polio, up to $70 million through calendar year 2018. A successful fundraising event held this Rotary year that capitalized on the great Gates match was the bike ride to end polio in Altura, Tucson, in the United States. And this year, almost 100 Rotarians raised over $13 million, an effort that was boosted by the support of 207 staff members who participated in an all-staff challenge. And I'm sure you'll be proud that the district that gave the most to the ride this year was District 3630 in Korea. And I very much, And I hope we all follow the example of District 3630 so that we can ensure that this dreaded disease is eradicated once and for all. Now, second, we need to be telling the amazing story of our polio eradication in our communities. Increasing public awareness of polio eradication and of Rotary's role in it is tremendously important. It ensures the success of our current work and leverages that success to create a legacy for the initiative and to spur further undertakings. Rotary members often tell us that our role in the eradication effort is underappreciated. But it's up to each and every one of us to tell our story. So please make sure everyone in your community knows how the passion of Rotarians is driving the global polio eradication initiative forward. And recognition of Rotary's contribution to eradicating polio continues to increase. This past year, 33 top-tier news stories focused on milestones in Africa, progress in Pakistan, and World Polio Day. Now, one point for all of us to consider. We have an important communications asset that other organizations simply do not have. And that's the 1.2 million members of Rotary and the 35,000 Rotary clubs in communities around the world. For Rotary to receive appropriate recognition, all Rotary clubs and Rotarians need to tell our story about the effort to end this terrible disease. Now, as I mentioned yesterday, we recently completed our Rotary brand strengthening exercise and have introduced a new visual and voice identity. So all of the templates and tools you need to prepare your visual and digital materials are now available in one place in the Brand Center on our website. And we'll be adding new resources to the My Rotary section of Rotary.org, where in one location you'll find Rotary promotional videos and photos, as well as templates on how to organize events and conferences that are geared to a non-Rotary audience. Because I think we can all agree that if used correctly, the new identity looks great and gives Rotary a more dynamic, modern look and feel, and will have a powerful, in my view, a very powerful effect if every club and district uses these elegant new designs and messages consistently. But you know, the visual piece is but 15% of what we're trying to achieve. The other 85% relates to how we talk about Rotary, both internally and externally. So the message out of Rotary International is join leaders, exchange ideas, and take action. And in addition, an important part of our initiative is to start speaking in our new voice to non-Rotarians. Our brand strengthening survey showed that we do a great job of speaking to ourselves. This is good, but we have to proactively begin promoting ourselves even more in the non-Rotary world. Because the reality is that we are one of the world's great humanitarian development organizations. We just need to do a better job of telling our story to the rest of the world. Now, at the Secretariat, we're supporting this effort by significantly improving and expanding our worldwide communications and public relations efforts. In 2015, the media relations team placed more than 500 articles in 20 countries. That's a 33% increase in coverage from what we had in 2014. Approximately 75 stories appeared in top-tier international news organizations, including the Associated Press, Agence France-Presse, BBC, CNN, Reuters, the New York Times, the Washington Post, and the Wall Street Journal. But if we are to achieve so much, if we can achieve so much with the clubs and members we currently have, what could we do if we were able to attract and retain even more members? And that's why a further organizational priority is and must be membership. And membership is not only about attracting new members, but about enhancing the club experience to retain current members. A strong club experience attracts new members and keeps existing members committed to Rotary for the long term. Now, we began this Rotary year with the second highest membership figure in our history. And we now have a tremendous opportunity to achieve our highest membership ever. But it requires each of us to make a special effort to attract new members and engage existing ones, especially those who may be at risk of leaving Rotary. Now, one key point is flexibility. In today's rapidly changing world, with all of its demographic transformations, one size very often does not fit all. And so we spoke yesterday on the important measures adopted by the Council on Legislation. Just like our brand and voice, these new enactments can only make a difference if they're actually acted upon. And so we encourage you to look at the options for increased flexibility in club meetings, attendance, and membership for those clubs that want it. And to help your clubs thrive and grow, in the coming year, you will see significant performance improvements and enhancements to tools such as Rotary Club Central and the Rotary.org website. So please, be creative in engaging new members and enriching the membership experience for your fellow Rotarians. Because without members, there would be no Rotary. And without our Rotary Foundation, Rotary would not be anything like the great organization that it is today. So our foundation is the fourth priority I want to talk to you about today. As I hope you all know, the Rotary Foundation, and again as you heard this morning, will be celebrating its centennial year starting at this convention. In more than a century of doing good in the world, we've changed millions of lives, and our foundation consistently earns the highest possible reviews from charity rating agencies. But we don't take any of that for granted, and we're absolutely committed to keeping our foundation as stable, as efficient, and as transparent as possible. And so I'm glad to say that contributions to the annual fund in support of our foundation are on pace to exceed last year's record-setting achievement. If every Rotarian makes an annual contribution before 30 June, we can reach our worldwide appeal of a worldwide goal of $130 million. Now, the Endowment Fund's current and projected net assets have already exceeded $1 billion, ahead of our 2017 target. And we're on schedule to complete the major gift initiative's $150 million endowment goal for the Peace Centers by June 2017. Our fundraising efforts are aimed at one simple goal: to help support Rotary Club efforts to improve communities worldwide. So what are Rotarians doing with the funds provided by our foundation? More and more Rotarians are using district and global grants to carry out projects, boosting our capacity to support Rotary's six areas of focus. 888 global grant applications, have been approved, which is an increase of 7.5% compared to a year ago. And we're implementing further changes to make grant applications a faster, more user-friendly experience. Now, the primary outcome of all these improvements is, of course, to help Rotary Club members carry out more humanitarian service with the maximum impact every year. And this brings me to my final topic, the power of partnerships. And there's no greater example of this power than the Global Polio Eradication Initiative, which Rotary spearheaded back in 1985. And today, our polio partnership is a model for future initiatives. And so this is why the Rotary International Board implemented a directive to secure more strategic partners to work with Rotary in our six areas of focus. And I can report that there are exciting partnerships in the pipeline, one of which is already up and running. Our strategic partnership with USAID through the RI-USAID International H2O collaboration brings together USAID's technical expertise and Rotary's network of grassroots volunteers to increase access to clean water, sanitation, and hygiene in developing countries. And Rotary and USAID have already committed $4 million each to Ghana, with an additional $4 million committed through 2018. So in conclusion, as we come together at this absolutely fantastic convention, we should be asking ourselves some probing questions about our future. Are we close to significantly increasing our membership, thereby expanding our impact and improving the lives of even millions more? Are we ready to set the pace for the international humanitarian agenda once our flagship project of polio eradication is achieved? And I'm sure you'll find some answers to these questions in the next few days, because Rotarians who make the commitment of time and resources to attend a Rotary convention are among the most engaged and most involved of all Rotarians. This is an exciting time for Rotary as our foundation moves into our second 100 years and as we continue to be a gift to the world. And we at the Rotary Secretariat, working as a united team with the Rotary International Board and the Rotary Foundation trustees, will be there for you in every way that we can to help our great organization realize its destiny ahead in this Rotary year and in the years ahead. Thank you very much. Kamsahamnida.